cashew, jackfruit, blueberry. Two of these fruits are very good for diabetics, and one is very bad for people with diabetes. Do you know which one it is? Put in the comments which one you think, and in this video, I will answer you and tell you the 10 best fruits for diabetics and also the 6 worst that you will need to pay more attention to. It doesn't mean these are forbidden fruits, that's not it. But you will have to moderate your consumption of these fruits on the last list. You will have to eat with more caution. Agreed? This video is part 2, because I already made a video about fruits for diabetics, but I mentioned the most common fruits. I didn't mention jackfruit. I didn't mention blueberries. And you commented a lot. I read the comments and I wrote down the 16 most mentioned fruits, the most frequent. So I made this classification based on your opinion, on what you really want to know. So I'm not going to explain the fundamental concepts such as glycemic index, glycemic load, composition fiber. If you haven't seen part 1 with the most common fruits, I'll leave it pinned in the first comment for you to watch, and then come back to this video here with the answers. Let's start with the list of the best, the 10 best, in descending order. And number 10 is cashew. Cashew is a fruit with a low glycemic index. It also has fiber in its composition. Cashew is a fruit that diabetics can eat with more peace of mind because it will not increase their blood sugar as much. Those from the Northeast commented a lot on the last video. You almost scolded me because I didn't talk about cashew. So if you are satisfied that cashew is on the list of the best, then don't forget to like this. I didn't ask for a like in this video, but you shouldn't forget to like it, especially since I said that cashews are one of the best. Number 9. For the Americans who watch this channel, I always ask where you are from, and whoever said they were from the United States always mentioned, almost always, a fruit, which is blueberries. Blueberries are also excellent for those with diabetes. Blueberries are also rich in antioxidants, which fight free radicals. So this is excellent for your health, as well as not raising blood sugar levels. Look, those who live in the United States are happy now. They're even laughing watching this video. Number 8, the lemon. Lemon is also excellent because it has a low glycemic load, a low amount of sugar. It has a low glycemic index, so you can consume lemon as much as you want. Look what I'm saying, few fruits diabetics can consume at will, but lemon is a recommended and excellent fruit, especially because you can't eat lemon pure. I hope you don't do that. But one of the few juices that can be safely consumed by diabetics is lemon. If you want to make a recipe with lemon and everything else, you will be taking advantage of the vitamins, and it will not harm diabetics, and it will not increase blood sugar. Number 7. Kiwi. It's still early to declare a victory, though, but there's also studies with kiwi that can help reduce blood pressure. So one more positive point for this fruit that I really like, which is kiwi. Number 6. Pomegranate. Pomegranate is also a good fruit for those with diabetes. After discussing kiwi, there are also studies with pomegranate that can improve high blood pressure. Why am I saying this? Because diabetes and high blood pressure often go hand in hand. Why? Because they share the same risk factor, in this case type 2 diabetes and high blood pressure, which is obesity. So it's worthwhile paying attention to the blood pressure too. Oh, and if you are a diabetic, you have to control your blood pressure, okay? You have to take measurements at least once a week. That's what I advise my patients, and it's good advice for you too, all right? Fruit number 5, acerola. This one in particular, I really like, and it is an excellent fruit because it is considered a citrus fruit. It also has several benefits, not only vitamin C, but it has antioxidants that aid your body's growth, your health, your metabolism. It is worth including acerola in this list. Number 4. Who likes pitanga? Pitanga was mentioned a lot. I was even a little curious, as so many people eat pitanga. I heard so much about it. It came up a lot. But if you are curious about pitanga, know that it is really very good for those who have diabetes. Number 3. Blackberry. Blackberry is also a recommended fruit for its entire composition. Number 2. Plum. Plums are excellent for those with diabetes because they have fiber, they have substances, they have vitamins, minerals, and they have a low glycemic index. And here I'm talking about the skin, okay? It could be black plum, red plum, either way. So plum is also another fruit that is among the best. And number one, this one is actually a fruit, but it also appeared in the comments, which is cocoa. And why did I add cocoa? Because cocoa can even improve your cholesterol. It has a type of good fat, which can improve cholesterol, can improve blood pressure, and will also not increase your blood sugar. Does cocoa count in the form of dark chocolate? If it is 70% or more, there are also studies. And what is the dose of cocoa? One tablet, 30 grams per day. You can have these benefits that I mentioned, but if I eat more, will the benefits also increase? No, they don't increase, okay? You will not further improve your cholesterol. On the contrary, you will consume excess calories because cocoa is very caloric and you will not enjoy any more benefits. On the contrary, if you gain weight, eat a lot of cocoa or a lot of dark chocolate, it will worsen the whole process of insulin resistance. Insulin will not be able to act in the same way. You will tend to have even higher blood pressure and worsen cholesterol. So you have to be careful with the dose, up to 30 grams of cocoa per day. Pay close attention to this. And the worst fruits that you will pay the most attention to, you have already seen that the list of the best had many good surprises, excellent surprises. I consider it that way. There are several benefits that I had not mentioned because there really was no way to mention all of these fruits. Let's move on to the list of the worst. And now, don't curse me, people. It's not my opinion, but fruit number 6, going in descending order again, is jackfruit. People from the Northeast were happy about cashew, but now they will be sad because of jackfruit, because jackfruit actually has a greater amount of carbohydrates. Diabetic people have to be much more careful with jackfruit. It's really not worth it if you have diabetes. It's not that I'm against jackfruit, but diabetic people will have to manage it much more carefully. Number 5, ACI, and this applies to frozen acai. Acai that you buy at the mall, but also to natural acai. Since it is an energy food, it carries a glycemic load, a quantity of carbohydrates, sugars. However, if you are dealing with diabetes, you should pay much more attention to acai. I eat acai almost every day, okay? I'm not saying that acai is bad, but I don't have diabetes. So you need to be aware of that. Acai has many antioxidants, always pasteurized, of course, in addition to being very tasty. But for those with diabetes, it will be on the list of the worst. It will be worse than lemon, for example, even than pitanga, okay? Number 4, and again you will be disappointed, is with the coconut. Coconut is also very high in calories. The meat of the coconut, as many have said, fresh coconut, and also coconut oil. Well, it's not healthy. Also, for those with high cholesterol, coconut oil is not a good option. But does it have benefits for the skin and everything else? Here I'm talking specifically about diabetes, okay? Number 3, you should also be more careful with, is the erraticum. Erraticum, like pitanga, I was surprised how many people asked about erraticum. I don't know if you eat erraticum. I've never eaten erraticum in my life. I really had to do some research to find out its composition, how it works in the body. But it's not a recommended fruit. I don't know if I'm answering your question. If you were one of the hundreds of people who asked about erraticum, you have to be more careful. Number 5 is melon. This is extremely common. I couldn't include it in the other video. I wish I had already talked about melon. It also has a higher amount of sugar, a higher concentration of carbohydrates, and a slightly higher glycemic index than the best fruits. The melon has to be taken in moderation because it falls under the fruits that require more attention. And number 1, the fruit that you should be very careful with, and this comment came up time and again, it really surprised me. In part 1 of the video, I classified banana as one of the worst because it actually has a composition, a glycemic load, an amount of sugar. It has a higher glycemic index than the best fruits, so it will be on the list of the worst. But the comment that startled me was this. Many people wrote, oh, I eat bananas, but I add oats. Guys, oats, most of the composition of oats is sugar, carbohydrates, sugars, which will raise your blood sugar. So if you eat a banana and add oats, Just because it has fiber doesn't mean it will become one of the best foods. If you add honey, as was the case, this one didn't come up that often. But there was one person who said, no, I'll add banana, I'll add oats, I'll add honey, that's it. Then yes, you have one of the worst combinations for someone with diabetes. Oh, and if I put chia on the banana? Also, you have to avoid these loaded fruits, or perhaps eat half a banana, don't eat a whole banana. Pay more attention to the quantity. Did you miss any fruit? I think I answered all the comments. If you want me to do part 3, write your question, which fruit I didn't mention in this video or in part 1, and then I will do part 3. From 0 to 1,000, what grade do you give? I always said from 0 to 10, but many people say, oh, you can only give 10. I wanted to give 1,000. So in this video, it ranges from 0 to 1,000, because if it's 1,000, I'll make more videos like this. Also write in the comments which part of the world you belong to. I'm speaking from Porto Alegre. What is the most consumed fruit in your region? Enter your city and the fruit you like most, which I always like to read. Now I'm going to leave a suggestion for you to watch. It's a video in which I talked about 12 tips for you to better control your diabetes. It's also a video that I'm sure will help you. If you haven't seen it, it's worth watching, which is this video here. Hug until next time.